guys. Hi guys. Very good evening. Glad to have you here. So we are waiting for 2 more minutes. We'll be starting our online yoga session with me, Ashna, and we'll just wait for the next 2 minutes. Till then, breathe and get ready. Hope you all are ready with your napkin, with water, wearing loose, comfortable clothes. Hi. So, just waiting for 1 minute more before we begin our session. Okay. So, namaste and welcome you all. I'm Ashna and I'll be taking you through this live yoga session, partnering with Bajaj Allianz Life Insurance, and it's a very great initiative by them, what they've started, called Fitness at Home. So because of this lockdown, as we all can see, everyone is very stressed, but no need to worry when you've got such a great initiative happening, Fitness at Home. So, before we begin the practice, I would like to tell you all that anyone suffering from lower back, neck or knee pain, please take it easy. And women who are pregnant or on their menstruation cycle, please go slow. Also, a humble request to everyone, just practice within your comfortable limits. Don't fight with your practice, don't force, just play around, and anytime you feel any discomfort or pain, recognize, understand your body and take a step back. There's no compulsion, no competition. So I hope you're all are ready. Let's get on the mat. Okay. Sit in any comfortable meditative posture, eyes remaining closed, neck relaxed, shoulder relaxed, spine well uplifted. Leave all your thoughts for the moment. Focusing on the natural sensation of your breath. And slowly keeping your eyes closed, draw your hands in front of the chest and we chant Om. Inhale deeply. Om. Slowly release your hands, take them behind your back. With an exhalation, bend front towards the mat. Inhale and slowly come up. Release your hands. And with a few gentle blinks, smile and open your eyes. Namaste. And welcome once again. I'll be taking you all through a quick easy beginner's yoga session, which will help you all de-stress at home, especially because everyone is working at home nowadays. So just to make sure that your spine remains healthy, you remain fit, I'll take you through a quick yoga session. Okay, so we all come up on our knees. I'm taking a forearm distance between the knees. A forearm distance from your left to your right knee. And from your right knee, exactly in front, taking a forearm distance, coming up on your wrist. Placing the toes exactly in line with the knees. So now you see the wrist, knees and toes are in one line. Okay? Inhale and slowly drop your back. Exhale, pull the belly, get the mid back towards the ceiling. Inhale and arch your back, look up. Exhale. Inhale, look up. Exhale, pull the belly, get your mid back to the ceiling. Inhale, drop your back. In case of any neck pain, keep looking front. Exhale, pull the belly. Inhale, up. Exhale. Inhale, arch your back, keep looking up. Exhale, pull the belly, get your mid back towards the ceiling. Inhale, drop your back, tilt your pelvis out. Exhale, keep continuing. Inhale, up. I'm sure you are following my counts. Exhale, pull in. Two more times. Inhale, drop your back. Exhale, last one. Inhale, down. Exhale, back up. And slowly come back and sit on your knees. I'll just give you some bit of information about this asana. Very good for your spine, very good to keep your lower back healthy. A very good warm-up practice when you're waking up in the morning and you know you've got a long day ahead, or any time in between your work, whenever you feel tired, you can probably take a few minutes, come up, do this asana, also known as Vyagra Shwasa or Tiger Breathing, Cat and Cow Breathing, as you know. So, this was something about that. And now we go down on the belly to do Cobra Breathing, also known as Bhujangasana. Once again, a very good way to strengthen your lower back, to make sure your abdominal muscles are healthy, and overall a very good asana. Another thing before we begin, again, anyone suffering from hernia, women on their menstruation or pregnancy, please avoid, take it easy. I hope you all have consulted your doctors or any yoga therapist before doing this practice. Okay, so now come down on your belly. I hope you all can see me. Placing your palms exactly in line with the chest. Okay, either keep your forehead or chin down on the mat, keeping your feet together, feet placed together and active throughout the practice. Now, as you inhale, you slowly come up, squeezing your buttocks. Exhale, go down, either placing your chin or forehead on the mat. Inhale, come up, keep looking towards the tip of your mat so that you don't strain your neck too much. Exhale, go down. Inhale, come up. Exhale. Inhale, up. Exhale. Inhale, come up. Keep continuing the practice. Exhale. Make sure your shoulders are rolled back, elbows are close to each other. Inhale, come up. keep continuing and follow my instructions. Exhale. Inhale, come up. Make sure lifting only from your low back. Don't use your arm strength to lift up like this. This is not what I want. What I want you to do is make sure you're using your lower back to give you a lift. So when you use your lower back, you only come up till your lower back takes you. No using too much of your arm strength. Maximum 15 to 20% weight of your arms. Exhale, go down. Two more. Inhale, come up. Breathe in from your nose. No breathing from the mouth. Exhale. Inhale, come up. Squeeze your buttocks and stay there. Hold the pose. One. Two. Keep breathing. Three. Four. Five. And slowly relax. Relax. And come up once again. You can come up on your knees, keeping your eyes closed and hands on your thighs. Observe the gentle changes you feel in your lower back. And slowly we come to a standing position. The next set of asanas will be something for your basic sides and to stretch your complete body. Okay, safely you can practice at home. Make sure you always practice within your comfortable limits. Now, taking a 3 to 4 feet distance between your feet, feet exactly parallel to the floor. Weight equally shared between both legs. Engage your belly, engage your pelvic muscles and place your hands on the waist. Stay there for two breaths. Keep your spine straight, back straight. Knee joints can be slightly soft. Never hyperextend any of your joints, be it your elbows, be it your knees. Never hyperextend, you can always leave them a bit soft. Okay. Getting your hands exactly in line with your chest, parallel to the floor. We inhale, center, exhale, twist back. Inhale, center, exhale, twist. Inhale, center, exhale, twist, looking towards the elbow. Inhale, center, exhale, inhale, slowly exhale. Keep breathing from your chest because your abdominal muscles are engaged. No breathing from the mouth, always breathe from your nose, from your chest, especially when you are doing asanas which engage the core muscles. Two more times, inhale, center. Exhale, inhale, center, exhale, inhale, slowly twist, inhale, center, exhale, twist, and slowly release your hands and get your feet together. Again, this asana is very good to improve your breathing pattern because you lengthen your inhalations and exhalations, which we normally don't do in our day-to-day lives. So always make sure that you breathe fully to the maximum, to your maximum ability. And once again, this asana, like I said, because you're working, anytime you feel tired, just get up, get off your chair, get off the couch wherever you're working. And gently do some spinal twists so that it releases all the tension in this area. Okay. Moving ahead, we get into some balancing asanas to make sure that you improve your focus and concentration. Once again, which is required for you all and for every one of us in our day-to-day lives. So, We begin with the tree pose, also known as Vrikshasana. Okay? Shifting your body weight completely on the left leg, slowly with the help of your right hand, get your right ankle up and place it on the inside of your left inner thigh. Once again, focus and listen to my instructions. Never keep your feet on your kneecap. Either place it down or place it up, but never on the kneecap to make sure the knee is fine. In case you feel you're losing balance, just practice against the wall. If not, you can practice where you are on your mat. Focus straight ahead on an unmoving point and slowly get your right foot towards the left inner thigh and hold. One, two, keep breathing. Three, if comfortable, slowly take your hands up. Four, five, slowly getting your hands down. With the help of your right hand, get your right ankle down. And slowly we begin on the left. Once again, shifting the entire body weight on the right leg, focusing on an unmoving point, engaging your abdominal muscles, chest straight, right knee can be slightly bent, and begin. One, two, keep breathing, breathe deeply from your chest. Three, lengthen your spine, extend your trunk. Four, five, with control, slowly release. With the help of your left hand, release your left leg. Okay. And now, getting your right leg straight up in line with your hips. Hips and knees are in one line. Stay there and just breathe. One, two, three. Balance, don't fall. Left knee can be slightly bent. Focus. Engage your core muscles. Engage your perineum. Slowly release. Once again with the left. Slowly get your left leg up. Uttita Hasta variation. Just to make sure that we balance well. Breathe. Four, five, and slowly release. Basic balancing asanas, very good to improve your focus and concentration. And from there, once again, we spread our feet 3 to 4 feet apart, keeping the knees slightly soft, spine well extended, body weight equally shared between both legs. Okay? And slightly taking our left leg in 30 to 45 degrees, right leg completely out. And now, as you see, my body is tilted towards this side. What I'm going to do is I'm going to tilt my body straight ahead towards the camera as I see you. Okay? Making sure that my alignment is exactly straight. I raise my hands at shoulder level. I hope you can see me. And from here, I open my palms. And on the next inhalation, I slowly drop down towards the right, getting my left hand up, looking towards the left thumb in Trikonasana. Breathe. Two. Any neck pain, you can keep looking down. If not, you can look towards your left big thumb. 4, 5, and slowly coming up and releasing the hands. Keep your legs position as it is, and now just turn your body completely towards the right side. Inhale and slowly go up your right knee exactly above the right big toe. Left heel remains completely on the mat. You inhale and slowly get your hands up, and if comfortable, slightly drop your neck and look towards your thumb in Virbhadrasana A. Also called as warrior pose. Stay there. Breathe. 4, 5, and slowly coming up. We once again practice Trikonasana on the left, turning the left foot 90 degrees out, right foot 30 to 45 degrees in, palms facing front. Inhale and slowly drop down. Make sure your chest and hip is facing front towards me. 2, if comfortable, look towards your thumb. 3, breathe deeply from your chest. 4, 5, slowly coming up. Once again, just turn the body towards the left. Go down on your left leg. Left knee is exactly 90 degrees above the toe. Inhaling, both the hands up. Looking towards the thumb. 2, 3, Trikonasana, again very good to reduce your tummy fat, very good to strengthen your waist. Also, the next one what we did, Virbhadrasana, a very good asana to improve your willpower, very good to strengthen your legs and also strengthen your determination power, your focus. So yeah, that's that. And now, I'm sure you all would be slightly tired. If not, I'm happy. And if you are, so. We inhale, get both the hands up. Grab your opposite elbows. On the next exhalation, slowly bend front and just hang there. In Uttanasana, forward fold, just hang. You can keep your eyes closed, keep breathing. Knees can be soft if you want. Just hang loose. And you can get your hands behind your back, interlock your fingers and stretch front. Feel the entire stretch right from your toes to your hamstrings, to your shoulders. Slowly inhale and come up halfway. Stay there. Slowly coming up. So another thing what I want to tell you all is that whenever you are in any forward fold, always come up halfway. Never come up fully, just to make sure that you don't get any blackout or vertigo. So we always pause, we come up halfway, take 2 breaths, and then on the next inhalation, you once again come up. Always remember any forward folding asanas you do, they are very good relaxation asanas, very good to de-stress you or your mind of anxiety, but not to do it for too long if you're undergoing depression. So just make sure that whenever you practice, you hold any of these asanas for 5 to 6 breaths. And if you're comfortable, if you are fine, practice for probably 8 to 9 breaths. Even when you're suffering from migraine or anxiety, once again, any of these forward bends, superb. Alright, so now, once again, we come down on the mat to a seated position, any comfortable seated position. And down here. Okay, so we get into the next one known as Ardha Matsyendra Asana, half lord of the fishes. Okay, so what you do is sit in straight, back straight, legs facing up 90 degrees. Bring your left knee up, bend your left leg at the knee, and place it outside your right hip. I repeat once again, you're sitting straight, bend your left leg at the knee first. And then get it outside your right hip. Getting your right leg up, placing it on the inside of your left knee. Okay, right goes outside the left and right foot on the left side of my left knee. Keeping the back straight. On the next iteration, I take my left hand up and slowly get it outside my right knee and gently twist back. Taking the right hand back, keeping the fingers cupped, gently twist, giving you a good spinal twist. Keep breathing. Looking towards your shoulder, breathe from your chest and slowly release. Once again, right foot outside the left hip, left leg outside the right knee. This time, right hand up and gently bring it outside your left knee and twist. Breathe. And slowly release and come front. Again, this asana is very good to again warm up and open your spine and also to reduce your tummy fat, to reduce your waist. Very good to massage your abdominal organs, your intestines, your liver and spleen. Very good for that area. Okay. Now, the next one we get into is Baddha Konasana, also known as the cobbler pose. Getting our feet together in Namaste, you would have seen everyone practice that. Once again, a very good asana for women who are pregnant. Very good to keep your pelvic area healthy, even for the men as well. A very good hip opener as well. So what you do is take a fist distance between your perineum and your feet. Join your feet together, interlock your fingers, place them under your feet, give a good lift to your spine and stay there. If you want, you can keep flapping. If not, you can just hold the pose and keep breathing deeply from your chest. Also called butterfly pose. Keep breathing. 3, 4, 5. And slowly with the help of your hands, getting your knees close and stretching them straight to the either directions. upavishta konasana. Okay, wide forward fold. Once again, a very good hip opening asana. Even when you're tired, what you can do is you can come towards the wall. When you're working on a laptop, what you can do is just sit against the wall, stretch your legs apart, and you can keep your laptop at a good elevated height and practice whatever you are doing, do your work. Again, when you're tired, what you can do is sit in Baddha Konasana for a while. If not, you can cross your legs and sit down on the mat. Always remember, it's very important and very good to sit down on the floor as much as possible. In today's day and age, all the time, whenever we are working, obviously at work, we don't have that chance. But now that we are at home, let's make the maximum of that, maximum use of our time to improve our health. Of course, our mental health, emotional and physical health. So this asana, again, I would recommend you all to sit every day for a while at least, and you won't even realize when your legs will keep splitting up and you all will be able to do a front split very easily. Anyways, it's very good for your back and for your hips as well, for your pelvic region as well. Just sit against the wall and be there, enjoy, watch TV, do whatever you want. So now, after this short break I gave you, we inhale, get both the hands up. Exhale, all the way go front, keep pulsing, keep going front. Feel the stretch coming in your inner thighs, keep walking your hands front as much as you can. Two more breaths, continue. And slowly coming up, we close our feet. And we lie down on the mat for our last asana called as Setu Bandhasana or Bridge Pose, Bridge Breathing. So, what you do is, taking one hand distance from your hips to your feet, inhale, pressurize your feet and slowly lift your buttocks off the mat, exhale, release. Vertebra by vertebra. Inhale, come up. Exhale. Continue. Inhale, up. Keep coming up. Pressurize your feet. Use your thigh muscles. Exhale. Inhale, up. Exhale. Two more times. Inhale, come up. Exhale. Last one. Inhale, lift up. Exhale. And slowly release your legs. Rotate your ankles, loosen your feet. And gently bend your left leg at the knee and slowly turn towards the right and come up and sitting again in any comfortable meditative posture, keeping your eyes closed, hands in chin mudra, spine well uplifted. Observe the changes you feel in your mind, body and breath. Eyes remaining closed. Mind has become relaxed. Body is energetic. Breathing has become smoother. On our last inhalation, we inhale deeply and while exhaling, we chant Om. Inhale. Om. eyes remaining closed. Feel the vibrations of Omkara in your entire body. Mind is totally free of thoughts. Breathing is natural. Body is absolutely relaxed yet energetic. And with a few gentle blinks, we once again smile and open our eyes. Thank you all. And now we'll just begin with a quick round of Q&A. Anyone has any questions, you can ask me. Okay, good evening. Till we have any questions coming in, I can keep giving you a few tips about your yoga practice. Most welcome, Kunal. Okay, I hope you enjoyed today's session. And so because of this lockdown, one thing I would like to say is that please make sure you don't stress too much and just keep breathing all the time. Be thankful, be positive, and make sure you always enjoy, live in the present. Don't stress too much, eat well, sleep well, and in between your work, make sure you're taking breaks. Probably every half an hour, what you can do is just get up, do gentle twisting, and that should be good enough. Make sure you are well hydrated. And hi Meenanti. thank you. For lower back pain, what you can do is, yes, you can very well safely practice these asanas. The first one, what I showed you, tiger breathing, again a very good asana for back pain. And the next one, what we did, bhujang asana, the cobra breathing, lying down on the belly, again very good to strengthen your back. And always, like I said at the beginning of the session, that make sure you only practice within your comfortable limits, don't overdo. So yeah, that's again one of the things. Neck ache regularly, what should I do? So always make sure that whenever you're working, a few basic tips besides yoga also, that make sure that you're working, keeping your laptop at the eye level, don't keep looking up or down. Make sure that you're always placing your laptop straight. Sit upright always, slightly keep your belly pulled in, keep your back straight. Never be like this, because obviously after 10 minutes you'll probably slouch back. So always just sit relaxed and do whatever you continue to do. You can do some basic neck movements, side to side. One thing what I would like to tell you is avoid the neck rotations. I've seen many people do the 360 degree neck rotations. Please avoid that. It's very bad for your cervical. Just if you want to do neck warm-ups or neck stretches, either do a side-to-side lateral one, or do a left-to-right, or do up, center, down, center. But don't do the 360 degrees rotation. And besides that, whenever you're using your phone, firstly, only use it when it's necessary. Secondly, if you have to at all, so again, keep it at eye level. That's very important. And no yoga for arm reducing. Well, there's nothing actually called as spot reduction. Let me tell you one thing, be it with yoga or anything else, if you lose weight, you lose weight overall, or if you gain weight, you again gain weight overall. So nothing specific what I'll tell you that do this and your arms will reduce. But at the same time, there are asanas like we did the Virbhadrasana or the Trikonasana. Again, very good for your arms, very good to strengthen your arms, very good for toning up your arm muscles. Also the twisting what I showed you and the forward bends that I showed you. Those again are some of that which should help you. And if you have a history of slip disc, please consult your doctor first. That I would advise you that your doctor, your physiotherapist, they will suggest you if you can do yoga. And then if you are in a condition to do yoga, you can safely practice the Bhujangasana, what I showed you. That is something very basic what you can do. Belly and arm reducing. Belly reducing, like I said, not any one asana will be a magic formula. But then again, like I showed you, Trikonasana, very good for your waist. Also remember, any of the forward bending asanas, when you're sitting and doing it, you know, they are very good to give a nice squeeze to your internal organs. And that again helps you to reduce the belly fat. It also helps you with digestion. One of the reasons why we feel that we're not losing weight is because of our metabolism rate too low. So these asanas will improve your digestion, improve your metabolism, which in turn will help you to reduce your belly fat. But again, reducing your belly or arm fat is not just happening of because of one asana. Your diet needs to be fine, and of course it also depends on your genes. Okay. Breathing exercises to keep yourself calm. Okay, so what you can do is, firstly, I'll take you through the normal deep breathing. What you can do is sit keeping your hands in chin mudra. If you're comfortable sitting on the mat, please sit on the mat. I would recommend that. If not, that's not a necessity. If not, sit comfortably on the chair like I am right now. Hands can remain in chin mudra facing up. Keeping your eyes closed, breathe deeply from the chest. Keeping your mouth closed, your neck and shoulder relaxed. The more you practice belly breathing, your abdominal breathing and your chest breathing for at least 5 to 10 minutes every day, you will automatically realize that, you know, you're feeling much more calmer and your thoughts are reducing. So the thing is that on an average, we have around 60,000 thoughts coming in our mind. Now you can imagine how mad anyone would go thinking so much. So that's why we say that you practice deep breathing, so that the more lengthier you breathe, your inhalations and exhalations are longer and smoother. Automatically, your number of thoughts start reducing, your mind starts getting calmer, your nervous system starts reacting in a better way. That is one. Secondly, what I want to tell you is you can practice Nadi Shuddhi, alternate nostril breathing. But that again has many restrictions if you're pregnant or if you're menstruating, or if you have any history of blood pressure. So, you know, we say avoid retention. Just practice normal nostril breathing, keeping your left hand in chin mudra. First two fingers of the right hand bent inside, rolled it in. Third and fourth finger open. So the right nostril, right thumb goes in the right nostril. Inhalation from the left. Close your left nostril with your left ring finger. Exhale from the right. Inhale from the right. Close. Exhale from the left. Practice Nadi Shuddhi 10 to 15 rounds, both sides. If you're tired, take a break after 5 to 6 rounds. Sit in chin mudra, eyes closed, and then once again practice another round. That's very good to relax your mind. And once again, we've just got 5 minutes left. Yeah, you can practice yoga in the evening. make sure that you've not eaten too much. At least 2 to 2.5 hours gap. 3 hours gap is recommended. Empty stomach. Also, if you're doing any backbending asanas, make sure you don't do any hardcore intense backbending asanas, because that again will give you problem to sleep in the night, because backbending usually makes you feel very energetic. So I would suggest do that in the morning. But definitely you can practice in the evening, not a problem at all. In fact, practice whenever you can. Just make sure that you've not eaten too much, because you won't be able to breathe to your fullest. And yeah, any asana for above 50 years. So what you can do is always begin with the gentle side to side stretching, what I showed you, the spinal twist. Also, what you can do is you can do some basic back, basic side bending exercises, taking a 3 to 4 feet gap between your feet. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Probably do this 10 times each side, 10 times the spinal twisting what I showed you. Also, you can do some gentle shoulder rotations, going as slow as possible. Feel each muscle and rotate your shoulders inward and outward. That's another thing you can do. Also, I'm sure if you're 50 or anyways fit, so you can definitely do the tree pose like I showed you, the balancing asanas, you know. If you're not confident, practice against the wall, that would probably help you. And the seated asanas what I showed you, all of these are safe to practice. And yeah, back pain I've already showed you what you need to do. What to do for belly fat burn, again, you can do Kapalbhati, because that again improves your digestion. The Agni element, the fire element in your stomach gets ignited, which improves your metabolism, which in turn helps you to work on your belly. But I wouldn't say that just do one thing and your belly fat will reduce. No, your eating habits are definitely more important. Best exercise for strengthening back for long meditation. Bhujangasana, Vyagrashvasa, same thing what I showed you. Also, you can do Shalabhasana. I'm sorry, we're running out of time. Probably next time I can be there for long to show you that as well. But quickly, I'll just show you. I don't want to leave you. So, again, lie down on the belly and just practice keeping your hands below the hips, below your hip bone. Place it on the thighs, keeping your elbows loose, okay? Keep it loose. Chin or forehead will remain on the mat. Inhale, lift your right leg up. Exhale, down. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, down. Very good. Once again, to strengthen your lower back. And anytime you're sitting for meditation, whenever you're tired, what you can do is just go against the wall and place both your legs up in air against the wall. Be there for 1 to 2 minutes and then again come back and again sit cross leg. So that's another thing. And thanks, as our mothers always need some special care. Yeah, absolutely, they do too much for us. And I hope my mom's watching this, and thanks to her as well. And yeah, so for all the moms, one thing I would like to say is that please don't overdo, especially during the lockdown. Just keep yourself as healthy as possible, because our moms always tend to do too much for us, and then in return we... Yeah, you can, in return we don't take that much care how much we should. So yeah, these gentle shoulder movements for our mommies, neck movements, sitting ones, you all can do, always do a combination, I would say. I've got last 2 minutes, so what you can say, what I'll say is that always combine, do a combination of your practice. do few forward folds like I showed you, the Baddha Konasana one I showed you, the cobbler one, you can also go front in that, the Upavishta Konasana what I showed you, so include forward folds, then the back bends what I showed you, Bhujangasana and Vyagrashvasa again for keeping your spine and back healthy, do that. If you've got too much back pain, I would say avoid forward bending, because that's always do more of back bends for back pain. But just to give you some general tips, so yeah, include forward bends, very relaxing, include back bends, keeping your spine healthy, include twists, very good to keep your sides and your spine again active, and very good for your posture as well, especially when you guys are working, when everyone is working. Then again, do some standing asanas like I showed you, Virbhadrasana, to strengthen your legs. And yeah, in the end, please practice 4 to 5 minutes of gentle breathing, deep breathing. And even when you begin your session, always do some silent sitting for at least 4 to 5 minutes, so that you leave all your thoughts aside, you be mindful in the practice. And yeah, so that you... you always stay calm, okay? And yeah, you always need to do warm up. So like Vyagrashvasa was our warm up, and definitely even when you're doing any of your yoga asana practice henceforth, please do some warm ups. Obviously, gently rotate your ankles, your toes, your knees, hips, you know, your shoulders, neck. So that's a good enough warm up for you. And yeah, you can follow me on Insta and on FB. My handle name is Yoga High by Ashna. That's YogaHighBy by Ashna, WSHNA. And yeah, would you recommend Shirshasana with lower back pain? Shirshasana actually gives you more of neck and shoulder issues if you're not doing it properly, not as such lower back, but then somewhere it does affect your overall body. So what you can do is, I'll quickly take this last one, and if you can't do Shirshasana, basically because that's an inversion, what you can do is just do Adhomukh Svanasana, a downward facing dog. What you need to do is just walk back, okay, placing your hands as it is, that is your position, that's your distance between your hands and your feet. Gently just push down, pushing your hips up, go down, gazing towards your belly, weight equally shared between both legs, shoulders rolled out, lengthen your spine, extend your trunk. If your heels do not touch the mat, no problem. Don't compromise on your spine. Just bend your knees and stay there. But don't round your back in any weird way. Okay? Just bend your knees and then extend the spine. Okay? And also, please just don't start practicing before that. Consult a doctor or a physiotherapist, yoga teacher, whoever you are in touch with. And okay, thank you. If you have any more questions, I hope I see you again next time. See you soon. And yeah, you can keep following me on Yoga High by Ashna. And it was really nice to have you guys join the practice. And once again, I would like to thank Bajaj Allianz Life Insurance for starting this initiative, Fitness from Home, which is a very cool thing and very thoughtful as well, which is definitely needed, especially during this stressful time. So thanks for having me, guys, and thank you so much for joining in. And yeah, just stay happy, stay safe, stay at home, don't get out. And like they all say, jab soch pe no lockdown, then life goals pe no lockdown. Okay, thank you, namaste, see you soon.